following is an MTV Cribs special presentation.
Matt, a lot of you keep asking me to show you where I live, and I'm pretty certain that this video is going to barely get any views. But, you know, the people asking are longtime subscribers, so this is how much I care. Alright, this is how much I love you. Now, this is kind of interesting because I realized this is the first place where I live that's not built by communists. My parents' home was built by communists and had that specific architecture. The one-room apartment that I showed you last time was also built by communists. And then when I moved over to the place that I got from my godparents, I was also made by communists. So this is literally the first house made by Romanians after the communist regime. So it's very interesting. Now let me show you how it's like outside. You know, the view is kind of boring. I'm in the middle of nowhere. And the reason is because it's a lot cheaper if I move in the middle of nowhere. Like, if I wanted to get a house like this inside the city, it would have been at least 5 times more expensive. But, you know, it's one of those neighborhoods, and people are still building. It's a freshly new neighborhood. All of this costed around $90,000. From what I understand, like, one of those little houses over there, they cost around $60,000. For Americans, this is mind-blowing, especially for the people in California. Yeah? Like, they just cannot compute. Like, they do not understand why are the prices so low. And, yeah, this is the room where I make my recordings. Now, it's kind of messy, but the reason I keep stuff like this here is to get a little bit of soundproofing, right? Because I don't have any furniture yet. I left all my furniture back at the other apartment, most of it, because I want to rent that so I can pay the mortgage here. Plus what I'm making on YouTube. So I got like this gaming chair over here, and I got this ladder, and then I spread them apart, get this blanket going, you know, and that's another chair that sits on the table. I put the towel on top of it. And I know it's ridiculous, but it's really cheap and it gets it going. Like, I get a lot of better sound quality by doing this. Now, this is the bedroom, and a lot of people have asked for the gazebo, right? There's the gazebo, but it's not mine. It belongs to the neighbor. And mine, when I'll have money for it, is going to go over there. A gazebo like that, from what I understand, is around $2,000. And it's not complete, like, it's going to get something else. But personally, I kind of see it in a cool way, because I can record YouTube videos in it. Although, I'm not really that excited, considering that I have a lot of expenses right now. I need to buy furniture and whatnot. And my gazebo is going to go there, and I got, like, all of the land that's from that wall all the way to the fence. So, between that and that place, all of that is mine, so I guess I can plant a couple of nice flowers, maybe some interesting trees. I don't know, haven't decided yet, but yeah, comes with the house. That also comes with the house. So let me show you something very interesting, right? Like, I got this bed because it was a Black Friday and it came really cheap. But this thing, like, when you install it, it's freaking massive and it's so difficult to actually find bed cover for it. That was a struggle to find something that fits. Now, my fiance is religious, right? So she insists on having at least one religious icon in the house. The problem is that the only place that I can have this is in the bedroom, because there's not much furniture in the house, right? Like, I can't put it in the bathroom, can't put it in the kitchen. So every time I'm going to bed in order to perform the fucking ritual, I have Saint Paraskeva staring at me, which is very uncomfortable, but, you know, what can you do? So, that's one of the things. And then I get, like, the TV. Now, the TV, which is set there, you can see that it looks like it's about to fall. That's because it is. Since the guy who put it on the wall, I wasn't home when they did the job. And turns out that there's, like, the socket, right? So it presses against the television. I know a lot of you in the comment section are going to be like, oh, V, you need to No, I don't have tools for the job, alright? I can't. Like, I do not have the tools, number one. The second problem is that I don't have money right now. So I'm waiting for the 21st of this month in order to get a guy to find the solution for this shit, right? So don't go in the comments like, you need to talk. I know what I need to do. Then this is the wardrobe, right? Now that room over there is completely empty. There's nothing in it. It's probably going to stay empty for years because I don't have money to buy furniture for that. But when I probably do get money, what I want to do in that room is to have a gaming setup, like a big TV, nice couch, PlayStation, you know, that type of stuff. Now, this is the bathroom. Cat litter was over there. And in the bathroom, I get like this thing, which is called a bidet, all right? I have never seen a bidet in my entire freaking life. This is the first. It's like a symbol of status. It makes me feel powerful. It gives me privilege. It is like that thing that other people don't have, and I do. And whenever I sit on it, I realize how privileged I am. So I really love it. I love my privilege. Okay? And it's white. Why privilege? Oh, there we go. Other than that, you know, like shower, normal things. Now, here's the hell on earth. These things. All right? Like, this is weird. I always lived in an apartment. I never lived in a house before. This is very bizarre and strange to me. And the main problem is that you think it's like one flight of stairs. I need to get up and down at least like 23 to 24 times a day. I counted, right? It's absolutely ridiculous. It destroys, like, you don't want to know what it does to my cholesterol, right? Like, my belly is being destroyed by these obnoxious things. They're made from hell, Jesus. Right. Now, here's something weird and bizarre, right? Because, again, I'm used to living in an apartment. So, I don't like just like going downstairs, and I'm in my pajamas, and I realize that anyone that travels here can see me, right? So it's just like something that I need to get used to. As you can see, there's not much furniture yet. That came with the house, and it's really cool. I mean, it's cool the way it looks, but like the moment you have like a little smudge on it, the moment you touch it, you leave fingerprints. And by the way, look at that shit. Look at it. Look. There's people there. They can see me. Why can't they see me? I want to see them. They shouldn't see me. Got the cat tree, right? Didn't leave it there because like the people there that are going to rent probably don't have a cat. And that's pretty much it. Then I get the kitchen, which is this area. And I think I got like, I forgot to show you guys something. I got like this little garden in the front, right? So all of that stuff also is mine. And then there's this place, which is like a very small bathroom, but I use it more for storage. So you get like the vacuum cleaner, other things, and the cat food, very important. And by the way, you'll notice that the cat follows me around everywhere I go. Like if I'm going to go to sleep now, the cat is going to come into the bed with me. And it's stressful. Cat, you're stressing me out, all right? Like just understand that you are way too attached. I need breathing space, okay? I need some levels around, cat. Please. Please just stop. Stop following me. God. Jesus, needy cat. It leaves me alone. That's a good thing. It's a good sign. Yeah, another thing that is kind of bizarre is that the view, as I mentioned, isn't that particularly interesting. But it's also the fact that, like, when I look out, people from there get to see me. So, like, right now there's no one in that house. But it's going to be weird. I am 100% sure that one time I'm going to go out of the window and there's going to be a guy over there looking at me as I look at him. That's going to be uncomfortable as fuck. Right? And also, I went to street level. I went the first thing I did, so in case you're concerned, yeah. I went to the street level and I looked into the room to see if I sit there and I jerk off, can anyone see me? That's important. You know, like, no, everyone who talks about it, when they show you a house, they forget to mention those important things. Because here, it's a big problem, right? The bed is kind of tall, and you get really nice viewing experience if you're there. Now, obviously, that's my backyard, so technically no one is supposed to be there. But then you realize that the neighbor also has a backyard there. So if the neighbor is up, they can see like through the window. So I had to buy like these very cheap drapes, which by the way are wobbling, like they're not big. It's very annoying, like finding people to do those types of jobs in Romania is very difficult. And I know in the comment section, hey, you need to, I don't have the tools, okay? I do not have power tools. I only have one screwdriver in the entire house. That's what I got. Right? No hammer, no nothing. See, it just, look. And I fed it. Like, I gave it food. Why does it stalk me? And it pretends like it doesn't stalk me, but like, it's just, wherever I go. What do you want? Go away. Making a video. Right. So that's my house. I mean, I really like it here. I definitely enjoy it. I wanna thank you guys for helping me realize my dream. Like, I always wanted my place to start a family. And yeah, I mean, the way I do it is I put half the money. My fiance is going to put a little bit more, and I also rented out the other place, which is good because I get to piss off communists. You know, like the two things they hate are people who work for a living and people who rent houses. Like they despise those things, and you know, like that's another plus for me. Anything else? Yeah. So it's still weird. It's bizarre. Because I'm not used to being in a house. Like, if you want to make a delivery, well, you can't. Because I'm in the middle of nowhere. Like, no one wants to come. Like, I need to eat for a living, healthy food. I can't just order McDonald's anymore. If I want to go out, like, let's say it's the middle of the night, like 11 or something, I can't. Because I don't have a car. I don't have a driving license, actually. Because when I was at med school, I had the choice to get a driving license, but I wanted to get good grades so I could get a scholarship. And I focused on the scholarship, which I got, by the way, but I didn't get the driving license. So there's that. And yeah, I'm in the middle of nowhere, so I'm relying on my neighbors to carry me around. And there's a bus that comes like once every hour. I told you, I'm in the middle of nowhere, next to Cottage the Cowardly Dog, okay? Like, he's going to be my neighbor. But other than that, it's a little bit difficult here. Though I really like it, you know, I really like it. I can hardly wait until I have the money to buy more furniture and make this even more livable. Because like right now, as you can see, there's still some work to be done, right? And it's not just the money that's the problem, it's finding the guy that will do it. And I know in the comment section, you need to blah, 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 blah. Alright, you need to enjoy this video. Let me know what you think in the comment section. And I'll see you guys later. Take care.